favorite burger places here in New York. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're gonna take you to our favorite burger places here in New York. And disclaimer, these are expensive burgers, it's not like McDonald's. We're gonna take you to three different places. For me, I really like medium rare burgers where it's red or pink in the center, crumbly, tasty meat, flavor is a big thing, the bun has to be good, maybe slightly toasted with a good sauce. I know my standards might be a little high for you guys, but I think you'll definitely enjoy these burgers. If you wanna see what my favorite burger places here are in the city, then keep on watching. We are at stop number one, Emily West Village. Their original location is in Brooklyn, but this is their Manhattan location. They take reservations, which is definitely recommended. Their burger is pricey, but probably, if I want to say my favorite one, it's on a pretzel bun and it has this really secret good Emily sauce. Yeah, each one has a different type of burger, so I can't remember what this one is, but we'll see when we get there.
Flavor explosion.
You got the good pretzel bun and the two patties with a special sauce. It's just so flavorful. What I like is that the patty is medium rare. Like you see the pink inside, even though it's a thin patty. I think what really makes the burger is definitely the sauce. It's almost like a slightly spicy, savory aioli. Yep, Emily still does not disappoint. It was really good, so flavorful. I just love the pretzel bun too. It's not quite your traditional burger, but I think that's why I like it. And this one, even though it is $26, it comes with curly fries. I will say, if you're a fan of this one, you should definitely check out the one in Brooklyn as well, because their burger is a little different. Instead of two patties, two thin patties, it's one thicker patty. All right, we are at stop number two, Union Square Cafe, which is by Danny Meyer, the owner or part owner of Shake Shack. So he has a special USC burger, and I think it's a really good classic burger. Make sure you make reservations here as well. All these places I made reservations for because you don't want to take a chance and you won't get seated. They're all really popular and they all have usually long wait times. So make a reservation at least a month in advance if you can. This one is a little more fancy and it's also a non-tipping restaurant. It's this whole thing that Danny Meyer was doing recently where you don't tip the waiters. The hospitality is supposed to be included in the prices. So we'll go check it out. So funny because we're so full, but they give you free bread. And we weren't gonna eat it, but now it's too tempting. Also, thing to note is that like both these places had fries that came with their dish. Union Square Cafe is by far the cheapest, only $19, but it comes with fries. It's kind of funny because we actually don't want fries because we're so full, but well, can't say no to fries. Here at Union Square Cafe, and I got the USC burger. We got the patty medium rare. It comes with bacon, cheese, and fries, all for $19, which is a really good deal. The bun is super soft, and I think it's a brioche bun if I remember correctly. It has these little seeds on top, and look how good that meat is. Perfectly medium rare, so let's give this a go. I feel like here, the meat is definitely great quality. It's really tender in the middle, and the cheese actually makes a good statement, which I like. I like cheese. I feel like at Emily, you definitely had more of the sauce that was the star, but here it's definitely the meat and the cheese.
Yeah, you definitely taste the meat because there's nothing else to distract you from it. Really juicy though, really juicy. There's not much sauce though, in general. Just like a very simple, no frills burger.
And the atmosphere here is definitely more white tablecloth, a little more upscale. whereas Emily has more of a trendy atmosphere. The fries, however, are not my favorite. They're kind of like, they're not quite steak fries, but they're thicker cut. They have that like potato-y taste, which personally I'm not a huge fan of. So it was definitely a good standard burger. I will say that flavor-wise, I still like Emily much better, but this is only $19, like I said. You get fries, there's no tip, and the meat is still really good quality. So I think this is still a really good option for burgers here in New York City. I'm getting really full, but we still have one more place left to go, so we're gonna head back to the West Village. We're at our third and last location, Minetta Tavern. Hopefully you can finish this burger, but it's gonna be the more pricey of the three, but I think we'll really like the flavor, and I think the beef is gonna be the best. So orange, but the lighting in here is not good. But we got the burger. It's a black label burger at $33. So it is expensive, but it comes with fries, and it has caramelized onions on top with a really thick patty, medium rare, and there's no cheese, which is interesting. So I think it's mostly about the meat. I think the meat will be the star. Alright, for a bonus burger, I'm gonna try au cheval. I've already had it in Chicago, but they just opened one here in New York, so we're gonna eat it here. Make sure you make reservations at least a few weeks in advance, possibly a month, just check online. But you definitely need to get the bacon and the egg, because without it, it doesn't taste as good. Good. I think the flavor is a little lacking actually than what I remember. It is a very simple burger, typical beef flavor, but this doesn't have that like extra flavor punch that I was looking for. And without the bacon, it's not as flavorful. So yeah, definitely worth trying. And I mean, it is $26 or $27, so it's on the pricey side, but that's what most of these burgers are. How was it?
It was, I could only eat half, but it was really, really good. It was, I think Chicago's like 5% better. Real talk, but yeah.
Oh, are you feeling me?
Yeah.
Oh. I have nothing to say. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, comment below. I'll also link all the Yelp links below as well. Give this video a thumbs up. Please subscribe for more food tours, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.